AMD's RDNA 2 has been launched into the wild, and first of all we saw the reference cards, with the 6800 XT offering the best value from AMD's side of the camp. However, fast forward a few weeks later, and we've now got the Taichi series from ASRock. This is a custom model, and it's also overclocked out of the factory. And showing you guys side-by-side comparisons with this card versus the reference 6800 and also 6900 XT variants, we can see that this Taichi here is coming much closer to a 6900 XT, and we'll go roll some benchmarks quickly for you guys and then talk about what makes this card so special in particular. So this card is one of the biggest cards I've seen here at the studio, weighing in at 1.75 kilograms, sporting two 100 mil fans and a single 90 mil fan in the center, where it definitely has the cooling to match its behemoth size. And we'll pull up the measurements here for the dimensions in case you guys are worried about whether this thing might fit or not in your ATX tower case, measuring roughly 32 centimeters long. Though the performance here was very impressive, both out of the box and also on the custom fan profiles, where if I had to select from any of the different fan profiles here, I would actually even on this card consider selecting 80% if I wanted to overclock or just keep my temperatures down over long periods of time. Where we saw at 80% 46 decibels, this was doing a phenomenal job of cooling, same with the 60% manual fan speeds, and then out of the box we're getting 52% fan speeds, but these were in pretty hot ambient, so delta adjusting these to what I usually test at and run the numbers here shows that this cooler is a phenomenal choice, not just for the lower temperatures, but also the low noise. So this massive specimen that I'm holding in my hands isn't all just looks. And speaking of the looks, we've got the RGB on the side of the card, which lights up the Taichi logo. Then the three fans, one of those in the middle, lights up full RGB. Then on the back plate, there's also the Taichi symbol and logo that lights up RGB, all of which can be controlled through the polychrome software with eight different styles to choose from, or you can switch the LEDs off, both in software or manually on the card itself with a manual flick switch. They've also got a switch for a dual BIOS, the quiet mode, and also the OC mode, which is the default out of the box. Since the card was already extremely quiet out of the box and performed extremely well, I decided to just give you guys what we're showing up here on the screen, the OC numbers, where what we saw in those gaming benchmarks was the Taichi was performing very close and sometimes even beating a 6900 XT, and it was doing so whilst remaining quieter and of course saving more money. Now compared to a 6800 XT reference model, this is really bringing a better cooling solution, and even then the reference model was doing a pretty good job, especially for out-of-the-box solutions from the manufacturer themselves. Though if you're getting a card like this, you're probably interested in taking it even further above the limits out of the box. And here's where there's some good and also bad news. The good news being that this cooler can support healthy overclocks, where when we overclocked it, we decided to quickly run Shadow of the Tomb Raider, where we got this thing up to 2.7 gigahertz and we managed to max the memory slider, no problems. But we only saw a little bit of a performance uplift because the millivolt gains were limited out of the box at 1150 millivolt. We also see the power being limited at 115%, and this took our wattage up not too much. However, the performance gains weren't so much either. Though if we do the flip side of the coin, undervolting, a lot of you guys out there are interested in undervolting these new cards in 2020, and here's where we saw a phenomenal drop in wattage when we dropped it down to 10,060 millivolt and we dropped it down to 2.2 gigahertz roughly on the clocks, this is where we saw the wattage going down over 100 watts. So this card right here will undervolt very well. However, the performance will dip since this is an overclocked model out of the factory. But whether saving 100 watts and keeping your card cooler and quieter is a choice for you guys, I'm not too sure. But I will start putting my Radeon profiles in the description for you guys if you wish to load them up and check things out for yourself. Though do keep in mind that I am running in a hotter ambient climate here, so if anything, these profiles should work on the majority of people's PCs out there. Though what about some of the other features on the Taichi? Well, if you want to download ASRock's Tweaker, they've just released a new version of this, and it will support different profiles out of the box, having silent and also overclock mode. And I will say that I was very impressed with how this software not only looked, but performed. So ASRock have definitely stepped up their game in providing software utility. Though although everything may seem amazing up until this point, custom models like the Taichi right here generally do command a premium over the reference models. This costing over $100 more than the 6800 XT does make it carry a premium. However, I feel like in this case with the Taichi, they've beefed up everything to the cooler, to the temperatures, to the noise, to the RGB, to the VRM implementation, and to the clock speeds, which makes it perform phenomenally well in the benchmarks. Now, in terms of outputs, you've got a HDMI 2.1 and also two display outs and a USB Type-C. And you've also got that 120Hz 4K 10-bit support at 444 RGB if you wish to play games in 120Hz full glory, which now works with AMD and the LG OLEDs. The one thing about the new RDNA 2 cards is when I tested the crypto mining performance out, they don't really do mining well in terms of what else is out there in terms of their price tags on those products. So if you're a gamer and you're looking for one of these, it's going to perform exceptionally well. If you're a cryptocurrency miner, then you will wish to look elsewhere. And then we've got smart access memory, which I did talk about in the previous review that we did on the 6900 XT. I'll link that up here for you guys, where it does work. It does give performance gains depending on your situation, but I found it to be kind of in a beta phase personally, where it was giving out some stuttering and in certain circumstances was giving out some funny buggers on the BIOS itself, to the point where we had to reflash the BIOS. So me personally, I would give smart access memory a couple of months before I used it, but it is a benefit that AMD cards are currently offering. And what about ray tracing? Here's where the 6800 XT Taichi will beat out the reference 6800 XT. And this all leads us now to a conclusion with this behemoth right here. And me personally, if you guys have followed me for a while, you'll know that I love big chunky cards. The bigger, the better when it comes to a graphics card. I'm a desktop enthusiast, and this card right here really hits the mark if you are a desktop gaming enthusiast. Where this cooler right here and the way ASRock have implemented this card is phenomenal. They've definitely stepped up things over the 5700 XT Taichi, which I liked that when that came through, but this thing is even better, and you've also got the performance that'll come very close and actually closer to a 6900 XT, and with a bit of overclocking will actually beat it, than that of a 6800 XT. So they've done a great job. However, you will pay a bit of a premium for this card right here. That's of course when it comes in stock. But that being said, the 6800 XT Taichi OC gets the big yes of approval here at Tech Yes City. And with that aside, I hope you guys enjoyed today's review. If you did, then be sure to hit that like button for us. And also let us know in the comment section below what you think of this behemoth right here in today's review. Love reading those thoughts and opinions. Just like this question of the day, which comes from Hip Dad, and they ask, nice video, is this contest worldwide? And they're talking about our RX 6800 video that we recently did in comparison mainly to the 3070 and 3060 Ti. Where at the start of the video, I said that we're giving away the RX 6800. That contest is still running, so go check that video out if you want a chance. So I already answered that question in the video, but that was mainly just to say thank you to the guys who watched through to the end, and I'll catch you guys in another tech video very soon. And if you're new around here, then you may wish to sub and ring the bell to see the videos as soon as they drop, and I'll catch you next time. Peace out for now. Bye.